When foundation trenches in clay soils are excavated to only shallow depths such as these, there will always be a risk of settlement and cracking. To avoid it, the obvious method would be to dig the trenches deeper so that the building rests on the clay at a depth where shrinking and swelling are small enough to be ignored. This depth we know to be around 3'6". But this would be costly even for such relatively light structures as two-story houses. The Building Research Station has therefore studied alternative designs of house foundations which, while not increasing costs, will afford the necessary protection against settlement. Let us consider each of these in turn.
This is the shallow traditional strip foundation which is so commonly used, together with its deeper counterpart. These are three alternatives: the deep narrow strip foundation, the straight board pile, and finally the under-reamed pile foundation.
The Building Research Station has carried out an investigation of the fire resistance of concrete beams in cooperation with the Fire Research Station to find out the performance of different beams designed to serve the same purpose. The beams were made at the Building Research Station under carefully controlled conditions. Most of them were made with sand and gravel aggregates to give a crushing strength of 6,000 pounds per square inch at 28 days. After curing under standard conditions, the beams were taken to the Fire Research Station, where a special furnace had been built for carrying out fire resistance tests on beams under load. When the preparations are complete, the gas burners on both sides of the furnace are lit. The furnace doors are closed and the test begins. Bye holes at each end of the furnace enable the beam to be observed. We can see one row of burners, the brick arch covering the exit flue, and the bottom and one side of the beam under test. Thermocouples hang from the furnace roof alongside the beam.
To MPs this afternoon on the constitutional consequences of yesterday's defeat of the Rhodesia Sanctions Order in the Lords. This morning, the Prime Minister called in senior ministers.
Noise is part of the price we pay for mechanization. And in urban areas, there's very little hope of ever reducing it. This film deals with the problem of a noisy environment from the point of view of persons indoors. To get detailed information about urban noise, the BRS and the Greater London Council carried out in 1961 and 1962 a noise survey over 36 square miles of central London. A 500-yard grid was laid over the central London map. Each intersection of the grid marked a position for recording a noise sample in a specially equipped recording van. There were 540 locations, many of them familiar London landmarks. BRS is carrying out research on noise barriers for use along motorways. The results could lead to improved noise conditions for people living near motorways and to increasing the area of land available and suitable for building development.
Scotland, in fact, has its own branch of the Building Research Establishment to study local problems.
One of the things that they're looking at the moment is the influence of the climatic factors in Scotland. We have a combination of high winds and high rainfall on moisture pickup in buildings and on the incidence of timber decay and insect attack.
The information from this survey is being handled at the Prince's RISBA laboratory, which is the centre of expertise on timber and its protection against fungal and insect attack.
This is interesting because it looks as if the smoke treatments are definitely more effective than the liquid insecticides.